It's very personal food. I could do a dish of food up and give it to person A and they absolutely love it and B in love with it and it's the favourite thing they've ever had. I could give it to person B and nah, bang average, right into it. It's very personal food. So when we come up with a tasting menu, it's hard to get everything that everybody's gonna like, especially so if we're doing sort of 8-9 plates of food down there and we're doing 800 covers a month. It's hard to cater for absolutely everyone's needs, especially this day and age where there's so many dietary allergies. At the moment, the menu is all of my ideas. I've got 5 chefs that work with me. If they have any ideas, it's good for them to come up with ideas. It gets their creativity flowing. You know, I've got a young team. The average age of the kitchen's 23, so it's good to sort of just get some sparks going and it gets them excited as well. But then we will develop that together. So the dish I've done for you today is our sort of steak tartare. Go up to Ripon to get our steak from a butcher, and they actually, the cut of beef that we use for this, they rear themselves. So not only are they butchers, they farm their own cattle as well. So we know it's been really looked after, it's been grass-fed, it's in pastures. Shorthorn beef that we're using at the moment, it's aged for a minimum of 50 days. And it's salt aged. We use the top side or strip loin. So if you cut it down, it's sirloin steaks. And we use the whole bit of it. So we use the fat as well. Obviously, we don't want any fats in the tartare or sinew. So we carefully cut away and we trim it up into fairly sort of, for a tartare, big chunks. I don't like to paste it. I like to have some texture when you're biting into it. So you're actually biting into a bit of beef. And we keep the fat as well, so we trim the fat down, we cube it up and then we mince it and then we roast it at 180 degrees in the oven and then just building the dish up really. We start with some caramelised artichoke, so we juice some artichoke, we keep the pulp, we use some molasses sugar because it's quite smoky and that really helps the beef as well. We caramelise the pulp of the artichokes and we reduce down the juice to a caramel and we fold that through so we have like a artichoke caramel on the bottom. We place our beef and we place some really finely diced cornichons and just make sure none of them are touching, so it's a nice even spread. You want the sort of same textures and same flavours for every forkful of the tartare. So we have some nasturtium capers, so basically when the nasturtium flower turns to a seed, we salt it and pickle it and turns it into a sort of nasturtium caper, so it's got a little bit of pepperiness there which helps the beef. And then we make an English emulsion, just egg yolks, a little bit of vinegar, salt, English mustard. So we add some oil and get this English mustard emulsion. We add a few dots of that on. And then we thinly slice some sourdough, usually left over from the day before, freeze it, and then we just cook that in some chicken fat at 160 degrees, just until it goes nice and golden and crisp. And then we just got some whatever garnish there is here. So I often ask Adrian, our head gardener here, to have some mustard frills on the go. So sort of every 10 days we get a new crate of sort of mustard frills. We look after them in the kitchen. Just pick a few mustard frills off. They go on, a few little mustard leaves, and then some flowers. So if you were to make a beef tartare at home, I would go and source best cut of beef. You want it to be for tartare fairly lean. So I go to a local butcher's and ask how long is your beef aged for, where do you source it from, and what sort of cattle is it. You know, Dexter's, Shorthorns, they're all sort of classic British cattle. So make sure it's quite lean, so you sort of sirloin meat or even your fillet, but maybe not so much fillet. You want a bit of fat on the top, and I would render the fat down. Traditional tartare, we all know it's got gherkin, shallots, egg yolk. You can go that way if you wish, it's absolutely fine, but I would definitely dress it in some sort of aged roast beef fat. I mean, it's all about the meat. It's the start of the show, you know, like the sourdough croutons. If you eat them on their own, it's just a crouton, you know. Everything on there is to complement the beef.